Hello and welcome to week 16, the final week in our semester. I am your course instructor, Heather Brandon, and I am going to help you wrap up the semester. First, some announcements, actually, just one announcement, and that is to please complete your student opinion questionnaire or SOQ online if you haven't done so already. Next, looking at readings, there are none for the week, but you may want to go back and peruse and refresh on the readings from the semester so that you can use them readily to cite some evidence when you are doing your final this week. The assignments that are due this week include your second case study, the SurveyMonkey participation activity, and the final exam. So, actually, this disclaimer for late assignments will not be in effect because May 24th at midnight is the deadline for all assignments, and I cannot ensure that I will get everything graded in time to be submitted to the department if you turn things in after that, because I have to get grades in by the 31st. All right, speaking of that case study, I gave you some feedback last week, but here it is again. Make sure with your case study you're really providing a concise summary. You're looking at the big picture, and a reader of your case study can leave with the big picture. You write from an authoritative stance and don't use the pronoun I think, blah, blah, blah. I feel like it would be best to just simply state what needs to happen. These are the results. This is the area that needs further instruction. Next, make sure to detail the follow-up assessments needed. That is criteria for the assignment that's included on the rubric. And don't worry about designing specific activities or interventions because that is the objective for Read 581. We don't want to steal that course instructor's thunder. So just keep it to these are the assignment or assessment results. This is the area of need that needs to be targeted. Don't worry about actually designing the intervention. So again, here's that sample from one of your colleagues. It's very straightforward, very concise, and someone within the reading profession can peruse this and really see quickly where the strengths and the needs for that student. The second thing you're doing this week is the participation activity. I know I spoke about the student opinion questionnaires, and those are more of the summative assessment for the course, if you will. And I don't get the feedback as immediately as I would like. So, in doing the SurveyMonkey, which is 10 questions that I put together, I think a few people have already done it. Thank you so much. This is not necessarily formative because it's not going to change what the course looks like for you, but it will change what the course looks like for future students and practitioners. So this feedback is very immediate, and I appreciate that because I can already start reworking things for next semester. So please, please take the time to do the SurveyMonkey. I really appreciate your input. And the last thing due this week is the final exam. So I did make some changes to what I had initially thought it might look like, so definitely pay attention to the following. So currently on Titanium, there is a final exam study guide. It pretty much consists of all the important terms, concepts, and assessments from the semester. They're definitely a lot. We covered a lot of content. The exam will cover all of that content from weeks 1 through 15. Now, I have set the final. It is in Titanium right now, but it does not open until May 17th at 6 a.m. So at that time is when you can first access the final. You can only take it one time, and you will have a 2-hour time limit. Initially, I had put 90 minutes, but I decided to increase it to 2 hours. So you will have a 2-hour time limit. There are some supporting materials that you need to download, and let me show you where you can find those. So here's our course. You will need to scroll all the way down to the bottom. And in week 17, the final exam week, you will see here is the actual final exam, and then here are supplementary materials that you will, or supporting materials really, that you will need for the exam. So download those, print them, make sure that they are on hand because the material is needed for three of the test questions. I'm guessing that if you were to take a look at the supplementary material, which does expire, you'll see that on May 25th it expires, because after that you won't be taking the final exam. But in looking at these, I'm sure you can make an educated guess as to what the question might look like. So that's kind of your help from me on that. But again, here is the study guide. Here is where you submit the case study. Here is the link for the final exam. And then here is the link for the supplementary materials that you need to print. Also, here's the SurveyMonkey, so please make sure you do that. All right, so I showed you those supporting materials. Those are going to be critical to your success on the final, so please make sure you take care of downloading those. The final exam will expire on May 24th at midnight, so you need to make sure it's completed by that time. It will consist of seven multiple choice that are worth 1 point each. There are 11 short answer, which should be able to be answered in a few sentences. Those range in point value from 2 to 4 points. Then there are four longer answer questions, which range in point value from 6 to 8 points. And for those ones, you'll need probably more than two sentences to respond because there are several different pieces to them. And then lastly, there are two case study type questions. And for your response to those questions, attachments are allowed. So if you wanted to, type into a Word document and upload that attachment or however you want to do it, you can actually submit an attachment for those two case studies, which are the last questions of the final exam. You may want to just type questions into a Word doc as you're working, so that way if something were to happen to your final, you have a record of your responses. All right, so that is the final exam. Again, it opens May 17th. You have 2 hours. Print the supporting materials and make sure it is done by the 24th at midnight. Going back to the student learning goals we set forth to achieve at the start of the semester. Hopefully, you feel like we have accomplished these things. Being able to select and administer appropriate literacy assessment tools and techniques for each component of research-based literacy instruction. So, we've definitely gone through early literacy, word recognition and decoding, vocabulary, comprehension, phonics, fluency, all of those different pieces, writing and spelling. Knowledge of the types and uses of assessment. So hopefully now you know a little bit more about the difference between formal and informal. And within informal, we have structured and then curriculum embedded. Within formal, there's typically the norm reference versus the criterion referenced or criterion based. And then we have the formative and summative screening, diagnosis, placement, progress monitoring. So we covered all of that way back in weeks 1, 2, 3, 4. You may want to go back and refresh because there are going to be many test questions about those different pieces and making sure you have a good understanding of those concepts. Next, being able to critically analyze and interpret results from assessments. We did that with the reflections, we did that with the case study, and we did that with some of the more recent discussion posts. There will be two case studies where you need to analyze and interpret assessment results. There's also going to be a couple of scenarios for some of those open-ended short answer questions where I may give you some information about how a student performed and you have to determine next steps. And then lastly, the ability to use assessment results to make informed instructional recommendations. So being able to take the assessment results and say, here is where we need to provide more instruction. So those were the goals for the course. I feel like we worked pretty hard to accomplish all of those things. And I know all of these pieces are going to be a part of that final exam for you to show one last time how much you have mastered these skills. Are we there yet? Yes, we are. We just need to do the case study, the participation activity, and the final, and you are all done with me and with Read 516. And that brings me to our closing. I'm going to launch you one last time with this Japanese proverb that says, "Better than 1,000 days of diligent study is one day with a great teacher." And that really was the purpose of this course, was to develop you into an even better teacher. A teacher who can be specific and intentional with instruction because you're using the formative assessment process and you're using data to drive your instructional decisions. Hopefully, this course has impressed upon you the power you have in all of the decisions that you make in the classroom, even the decisions for what and how you will assess. Convey greater implications to the student about what is important for reading. And so I hope that you will take that to heart as you move forward in your practice and your career in education. And if you need anything further from me, you can definitely always email me. It has been a pleasure working with you this semester. Good luck on the final. Let me know if you need anything.